Hello everyone. Welcome to this spoken tutorial on construction of the dome of the digester tank. The tutorials on digging of the pit and laying foundation are available on spokentutorial.org website. In this tutorial, we will learn the step-by-step procedure for constructing a dome. So what is a dome? Dome is an arch-like structure placed on the digester tank where the biogas is collected. Construction of the dome is a very interesting and important procedure. Items used for construction are steel rods, chicken mesh, and steel wire. Detailed specifications of these are mentioned in the tutorial on material required. Let's begin. First, make a circle of 7 feet 6 inches diameter with lime powder. Now put 12 marks on the circumference of the circle and number them from 1 to 12 as shown. These 12 marks should be separated by a distance of 2 feet from each other. Next, hammer 12 10-inch steel rods all along the marked circumference. Hammer the 10-inch steel rods up to 2 inches in the ground. Remember that they have to be removed later. Next comes the use of 12 feet long steel rods. With the 12 feet long steel rods, we'll make an outer circle around the hammered 10-inch steel rods. I will now tell you how to make a circle using the hollow rod. Use an iron rod having hollow ends. With this iron rod, bend the 12 feet steel rods to form a circular shape. Then place the circular steel rods around the smaller 10-inch steel rods as shown. We will need 2 12 feet rods to complete the circle. Now, tie the circular steel rods to the 10-inch steel rods using steel wires as shown. Ensure that the knot is tied very tightly and the steel rod circle is very stable. This is the base of the dome. Hence, it has to be very strong to bear the load of the plastered dome later. Now, hammer a 4 feet and 2 inches long bamboo stick in the center of the circle as shown. Hammer the bamboo stick up to 2 inches in the ground. Ensure that it can stand firmly by itself and can be easily removed later. This bamboo stick should be able to temporarily support the frame of the dome. Now, let's start building the frame of the dome. Again, use the hollow iron rod and bend a 12 feet long steel rod to form an arch-like shape. This arch will give the semicircular shape to the dome. Hence, ensure that the arch is symmetric on either side when bent. Similarly, bend 2 more 12 feet rods to form arches. Let me explain exactly how the arches have to be placed on the circumference using a diagram. Secure one end of the arch at rod number 1 and the other end of the arch at rod number 7. This will ensure perfect symmetry to the arch and it will rest on the bamboo stick in the center. Use steel wires to tie the arch together with the hammered 10-inch steel rod and the circular ring. For tying, make a knot-like structure with the steel wire as shown here. Do likewise at the opposite end of the arch as well. Next, we will tie 2 more arches. Secure the second arch to rod number 3 and rod number 9. And secure the third arch to rod number 5 and rod number 11. The 12 feet steel rod arches should be at an angular separation of 60 degrees at the base. Now we have 3 arches for the frame of the dome. Next, carefully slide the steel rods at the top such that a small gap is left open in between. Tie the steel rods using the steel wires as shown. Intersection of the 3 arches will look like a triangle. The sides of the triangle should be approximately 2.5 inches. As shown in the image, the top view of the framework should look like this after tying. What you see here is the mason showing the exact position of the open triangular gap using the bamboo stick. This gap is where the main gas pipe of 1 inch diameter will fit. Once the arches have been fixed, we have to make circular rings with the remaining 12 feet steel rods. First, let us understand how to make these rings with the help of a diagram. This is the framework we constructed so far. Circular base, semicircular arches. Now we need to fix 8 circular rings such that they can be placed on the arches as shown. The rings have to be uniformly separated by a distance of 8 inches between each of them. To make circular rings, start from the top and gradually move downwards. Two things to keep in mind while making circular rings are: the length of the steel rod would depend upon the position of the circular ring on the frame. Longer steel rods would be required as we gradually go from top to bottom. We will first have to cut the steel rods to the required length before we fix the rings. So, let's do that. For the first ring, which is the smallest ring at the top, we will need approximately 4 feet and 7 inch steel rod, adding 2 feet extra for tying. Diameter of this circular ring will be 10 inches. For the second ring, we will need approximately 7 feet and 1 inch of steel rod. Diameter of this ring will be 1 foot and 7 inches. For the third ring, 9 feet and 8 inches steel rod would be required. Diameter would be 2 feet and 5 inches. Fourth ring will require 12 feet and 3 inches long steel rod. Diameter of this ring will be 3 feet and 3 inches. Fifth ring will need 14 feet 10 inches long steel rod. Diameter of this ring will be 4 feet 1 inch. Sixth ring will require 17 feet 4 inches long rod. Diameter of this ring will be 4 feet and 10 inches. Remember, as mentioned while explaining the first circular ring, an extra 2 feet has been calculated for tying the rods together with steel wires for all the 8 rings, and the diameter for all the 8 rings is calculated excluding the 6 inches. Now comes the 7th and 8th ring. Both will be used for making the circular rings and also the entrance of the dome. Measurements for these two are: 7th ring will require 20 feet and 10 inches long steel rod, and for 8th ring 23 feet and 5 inches long steel rod would be required. Keep in mind that this includes the measurement for the bent rods as well. As soon as 3 circular rings are placed, an important thing to be done is place 6 bamboo sticks of length 4 feet in an inclined position inside the frame of the dome. Note that bamboo sticks have to be spread out uniformly from the center of the base and should be firmly rested against the circular rings or the arches. These sticks will further give support to the frame of the dome. Please note, if you follow the measurements mentioned earlier, then you will get a uniform distance of 8 inches between each circular ring. To confirm this, use a 1-foot steel scale having 2 hooves. The distance between these 2 hooves should be 8 inches and it should fit in between 2 circular rings as shown here. However, you may ignore minor variations, if any. Just after placing the 6th circular ring, an important thing to be done is to fix vertical rods on the frame. I will explain how to do that. Between 2 half arches, fix a steel rod of length 5 feet and 5 inches, bisecting the 2 main arches. Tie this rod using steel wires from the base ring up to the 1st ring as shown in the image. Similarly, fix 2 more steel rods of 4 feet and 7 inches bisecting the half arch, and the 5 feet and 5 inches steel rod. Tie these 2 rods using steel wires from the base ring up to the 2nd ring as shown. Please note, between the 5th and 6th 10 inch hammered steel rod, do the following. The 4th, feet 7 inches long steel rod has to be bent and tied to the sixth ring. This is done to make space for the entrance of the dome as shown in the image. Note that in both cases, extra 3 inches have been left at the top for the ease of tying the steel wire to the circular rings. Now, we will fix the last 2 circular rings, that is 7th and 8th ring. However, it is to be noted that between 6th and 8th ring will be the gap or the entrance to the dome. This gap should be big enough for the mason to enter inside the dome. Size of this gap would be approximately 2 feet of width and 2 feet of height. Use 7th and 8th ring to make the gap of the mentioned size. Bend the 7th rod to make the upper side of the entrance as shown in the image and bend the 8th ring downward. This will make the lower end of the gap or entrance as shown in the image. Now tie the bent 7th and 8th rings firmly with steel wires. Next comes covering the frame of the dome with chicken mesh. Use a metal scissor to cut the required size of the chicken mesh. Start covering the frame tightly with the mesh from top to bottom. To tie the mesh to the frame, stretch the mesh tightly and tie it to the frame with steel wires. This can be done by using a metal hook. To tighten the layers of the chicken mesh, insert the hook into the holes of the 2 layers. Rotate the hook by stretching the mesh and simultaneously entwining the meshes. Please note, if the chicken mesh is not stretched tightly, then cracks might appear later while plastering the dome. Remember to leave an extra 4 to 5 inch of chicken mesh at the nape of the frame. Reason for this will be explained while fixing the dome on the digester tank. The entire frame should be covered with 3 bundles of chicken mesh. This would form approximately 3 layers over the dome. The multiple layers of chicken mesh will help to hold the cement firmly while plastering the dome. Chicken mesh covering the entrance to the dome should be cut with scissors. What you see here is the mason getting inside the dome through the same gap or the entrance. Once the chicken mesh is fixed, remove the bamboo sticks placed inside for support. Please note that the sticks have to be gently removed so as to not disturb the frame of the dome. Do so carefully and slowly. The mesh dome is now ready and can be placed on the digester tank. Before shifting, untie the 10-inch hammered steel rod from the base ring and make sure of retying the loose ends of the mesh. This brings us to the end of this tutorial of constructing a dome for the biogas plant. Fixing of the dome on the biogas plant will be explained in a later tutorial. Let us summarize. In this tutorial, we learned the step-by-step procedure to construct the dome of the digester tank. This video was created by Spoken Tutorial Project with inputs from Rural ICT Team, IIT Bombay. More information on these projects can be found at these links. This is Bella Tony, along with the animation team of the Spoken Tutorial Project, signing off. Thank you for joining.